Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. How are you doing, Imam Asif?
Walaikum assalam wa rahmatullah. How are you?
Good, alhamdulillah. We've been fasting for a few days now and getting used to it, inshallah. So I hope everybody watching as well is getting used to the fast and finding some barakah in this month. On that topic of barakah, what we kind of wanted to cover today was just, you know, what extra dua, you know, what things that we can incorporate through our daily routine, maybe a number of istighfar or some reminders that we can use so that we can make some of these fasts a little bit better and with a better connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Yeah, so what are the du'as and what are the things we can do? First of all, we need to understand a general hadith narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that there are three people who, whenever they will ask dua, their duas won't be rejected. One of them is a just ruler. Second is a fasting person when he or she breaks his or her fast. So their dua would not be rejected, subhanAllah. And the prayer of the oppressed person, his or her prayer won't be rejected. So for us, the context is actually the fasting person. So Rasulullah ﷺ didn't say that you have to ask this specific dua while fasting, your prayer will be accepted. Rasulullah ﷺ said, whenever you are fasting, your prayer won't be rejected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then actually one of the narrations says that the dua of the fasting person rises above the clouds and the gates of heaven are open for it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may he be glorified, says, By my glory, I will answer you even if it is after a while, but I will going to answer you. And this is mentioned in Sunan Tirmizi and the Sahih Hadith, authentic Hadith. So basically, we can ask whatever dua we are thinking of in our own language. You don't even have to say out loud. You can even ask like Zakariya alayhi salam, Nida and Khafiya, like talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and basically say what you need. That's the essence of dua. And inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to ask dua in this fashion, inshallah.
Subhanallah, subhanallah, it's beautiful. So inshallah, we'll see you tomorrow, Imam Asif. This is a beautiful reminder about dua. So hopefully we can take practical steps like writing down our dua and reading them every day, or those kinds of things. And we'll see you inshallah tomorrow. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah.